And they told me, they was like, yeah, Mr. Boyd, yeah, if you pay this off, you pay this $600 for the next 30 years. I said, 30? I said, I'm never paying y'all that. She's like, excuse me? I said, I'm never paying y'all that. I'm not. I said, I started off, it was like, my loan was like $25,000, and now it's up to $60,000. Nah.
And so you think about it. You don't want to be enslaved. I'm a slave for y'all.
Yeah.
Like, so then I'm like, hold on. And I started watching people like Damon Dash and listen to other people. And I'm like, hold on.
Yeah.
So I think with me, and I begin to think about my purpose. My purpose, and the Bible says, oh, no man, nothing but to love them. So that, none of that. So I begin to think about not only just paying off debt,
right,
but how can I leave a legacy for my children?
Right.
Because I don't want y'all to, you know, if I knew what I know now, I would have did things a little differently.
Mm-hmm.
If I went to college, I would have went with the mindset of becoming a teacher, opening up my own school.
Right.
Because guess what? That's what a lot of people do.
Mm-hmm.
If you think about it, some people go into the mindset of getting a medical degree, and then they open up their own medical company. They're not working for anybody else. Somebody else is working for them. So I think if we go in it like that with the mindset of ownership
yeah,
versus you getting your degree with the mindset of working for somebody.
Right.
Like, I'm like, that, like, that's a slave mentality for me.
Right.
And so I had to reprogram my mind. And after I reprogrammed my mind, nothing else, nobody can tell me. So now I'm on this journey. So after I got to writing books and I begin to set plans, the Lord put on my heart, you know, I minister and I coach and I teach. My first thing was to open up my own school.
Okay, but, hold on one second.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's get into what actually is it that you accomplished over this, over your journey. So now you started off of being a teacher, you went into education with many years of college. Was it during these years of college, or was it once you got into the workforce that you like, you know what, this ain't what it is, and I'm finna go and start this? So like, what year or when, what time appeared in your life was it like, you know what, I'm finna go do growing up empowerment life coaching, that's what I'm finna do? Like, what was the turning point that you had?
So think about it. My mind shift on money had to change.
Mm-hmm.
Because if I go in my closet, I'll say in 2007, I had a business plan
mm-hmm.
to open up a group home.
Mm-hmm.
2019, had a business plan to open up a daycare.
Mm-hmm.
I began to search around for buildings and all of this thing. So money became a barrier for me. Mm-hmm. I got to saying, oh, I need this much money to open up this and open up that. And then I began to really pray about it for real. And I'm like, this is not, listen, and the debt comes, you know, you gotta pay this debt, you gotta do all of this. And the turning point came for me during this pandemic.
Right.
And I began to see people lose their jobs. And I'm thinking, if you have multiple streams of income, when one, you know, one, and I mean lucrative, I'm not striving for petty cash or pettiness or anything like that. Lucrative income to actually can sustain me and my family during a pandemic. You know what I'm saying? And so what I found out, my biggest barrier was myself and my thinking. And so I had to go from thinking I need $1 million to open up this business to realizing use what you have.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I began to change my mind, I began to, I made a plan for life coaching. I had to really first think about everything that I do. What can I do that would allow me to do everything that I do all in one business? I'm a teacher, I'm an educator, I coach teachers, I coach parents, I coach husbands and wives, as a minister, I coach, you know, I preach Sunday school, I teach this. What can I do that would allow me to do all of this? I coach for Cardinal Stretch, and I think about how they paid me. Well, if they paying me well, then I know whoever started the program getting paid well, right? And so I thought about it. I said, I have all the tools I need to do my own thing. And so what I began to do is I got the necessary certificates that I needed for my life coaching. And what I found out, it was the turning point. I kid you not, what started growing up empowerment was when I was taking the classes to get my certification for a master, to be a master life coach. And when I tell you, remember, on the journey of me going to those classes, I was writing my book, Grow Up on Purpose. Mm-hmm. And I'm finishing my doctorate degree all at the same time. And when I took the classes, they was teaching me stuff already. Everything that I knew, they was affirming everything that I was saying. Everything that I was teaching other people. So I began to say, if they can do it, I can do it. As a teacher, they begin to talk about building a curriculum with your life coaching. Write more books. God has given me the okay to do this. And now I'm at the point now, I've learned what I need to learn. And it's time to just go ahead and do. And you know what? Do what God has called me to do. But I know what? It's not all about me. You know, I've also learned what not to do. So through the many years of opening this business, I see other people with business. I learned what not to do.
Right.
And so I have to realize that I'm here to service people, for one.
We are servant.
Yeah. You know, I finished my master's degree in at Silver Lake College, and we were under servant leadership. Greenleaf, that's what our motto was, bringing servant leaders in public sector. And so I have to stay focused, keep my eyes on my vision, keep my eyes on helping people. Mm-hmm. If I got two clients that come in here a month, I will say, I have to treat them and service them as if I had a million clients or as if the whole world know me. You know what I'm saying? So I think we have to really stay focused and keep our mind clear from outside noise and even our self-talk. We have to talk positive. We have to really motivate. It takes self-motivation. David said it like this. He said, I encourage myself. And so we have to get to that point. So for me on this journey, I'm satisfied now. You know, it's cool. I'm cool how the clients coming in now. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because there will be a fluctuation at a time. But I have to allow time for my business to become known. Mm-hmm. I have to allow time for preparing for where I want to go. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So we want the now so quick.
Right.
But when you see, you know, what the Amazon dude, I was just saying to
Jeff
one person. He actually started in his garage.
Yeah. It's crazy. Like I worked at Amazon when I stayed in Charlotte.
Yeah.
I worked at Amazon, and I used to get pissed off because I'd be like, when you be in the break room, like I never had a job I liked. Pretty much, I can say that. Like I always in business, I'm like, why am I here making these other people money? That's
right.
How I always think. Even in the school. Even whatever I did, even when I worked at Summerfest, it's like I took stuff from it. Yeah, I learned. But at the same time, I'm like, I always wanted a business since I was little. Like, I was like, I want something like that. I don't know what it is, but I want to have that is mine. Like,
right.
I want that. So when I got older, Puffy was the person that inspired me. Like, when I made that logo, I had him in mind, like, well, where it is.
Right. Right.
Yeah, because I see this in New York, like on the side of a building
right.
or something.
Right.
So, like, that's what I always think about that, too. But in this journey, what I'm going to segue into now is, like, since we don't have that much time left, real quick, I want you to tell people what you got going on and give some encouragement to those that's kind of on the fence of, I'm gonna step on faith and start this business, or am I just gonna stay with this money that's okay, but I still don't own anything. So if I die right now, what am I gonna leave my kids? What
right.
What the Bible says that a righteous man leaves his inheritance for his children's children.
Right.
So, you know,
and the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous.
Yeah, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. So, So, what, like, give some encouragement to the people that globally that's going to see this eventually. I know that this, I said it before, I'm going to be on the Breakfast Club, and this might be the way. I told Charlamagne when I met him, I said, I'm going to be on your show one day. He said, I believe you, brother.
Me
and
too.
I gave him some of my merch. He's like, I believe you. So, what's some words of encouragement since we're going to be signing off soon? What you want to tell people out there that, you know, they ready to get to the building?
So I think we have to first of all realize that it's our time. It's your time. And all it takes is for you to say it to yourself and mentally shift yourself and say, it's my time. And I have what it takes. You have what it takes to produce that which you envision. scripture teaches to write the vision, make it plain. But this one thing I say to people all the time, do not set goals. It makes no sense to set goals and write courses of actions if you don't plan to work towards them. Mm-hmm. So you have to, even if you have to take make many goals within your small and short-term goals, do so. For example, this week, my goal is to finish my 2 classes to get my doctorate degree. So I had to make up in my mind and say, you know what? I'm going to finish 2 assignments this weekend. And so you had to ask yourself, is what I'm doing helping me reach my ultimate goal? So we have to get rid of the things that don't matter, stop doing things that don't matter, and then work on the things that really do matter. And I think the biggest issue for me, for a lot of us, is the way we think.
Right.
The way we think about ourselves. Mm-hmm. I think the biggest thing for us is stop looking at everybody around you, because everybody around you do not share the same purpose or share the same goals as you. So begin to keep your eyes on your vision and your vision only. And when obstacles come, guess what? We have to plan. When I do goal settings with my clients, guess what? There's room in there for obstacles to happen, because obstacles and difficulties will come on your journey to growing up on purpose, your journey to fulfilling your goals. And so what happens when those obstacles come? You make what? You make provision for obstacles. And so my biggest goal and my biggest thing to say to people...